Hello again. Okay, continued because it's the 5 days over the hill, and means I'm over for 40. And where I left off was the right wing secular Christian extremist fanatics who don't understand the difference between free will and Bible version, versus like Wiccanism, which is do what you will, but harm none. They don't understand free will. Free will does not mean you get to do whatever you want, whenever you want, to whoever you want. It means free will to do what you want for yourself without interfering with someone else's free will. When that you do, you generally get arrested because you've broken someone else's rights. And here in the United States, there is a large portion of the right-wing religious misguided ignorant people who are teaching their children and new generations of people that it's okay to discriminate and practice bigotry and preach hate against people they deem as less worthy in the eyes of the Lord, in our Holy Father, God, he doesn't see any one person differently than another. And the mention of free will, it's free will for all. And that's pretty much it. I didn't lose my video before, just my energy saving whatever thing settings timed out. Surprisingly, non-activity, screen monitor, whatever, kind of went dark, and my video's still running, and I couldn't see myself, so I kind of panicked. It's like, wait, I'll be back. Oh, by the way, I'm making some longer videos just because you can make bigger videos now. And my last one loaded up quite well, so I decided to continue making another one. And so here I am, sitting down. It's Friday evening. Canceled my game night. Column and just because two people weren't going to be there. Fairly, well, I'll sit back, watch TV, watch the news, and I haven't really made too many comments on everything else that's been in the news. And love the federal judge who wanted to, or who, mentioned block that yes, the don't ask, don't tell, the practice of don't ask, don't tell is in fact, unconstitutional. Personal belief I've held for a while now that, as American citizens, any American citizen who has the ability to serve has the right to serve. Komodo Dragoon has raised this thing about don't ask, don't tell, and will it allow intersex people to serve? And I mentioned previously that I did serve. When I joined, they knew something was different about me. Just because some of my lab work was a little weird and some of my body was a little different. But I didn't have an issue with not serving. There are still medical requirements that you must meet, but if you meet them and you happen to be intersex, you can indeed serve. And so it's kind of like, just because you're intersex does not mean that you're not able to serve. There again, there's a lot of nonsense with some of the older medical literature about conditions. I'm Mosaic, okay, probably a bit more than Mosaic, more than a few ways, but it's for many, many years they mentioned mental retardation, and it's a mental handicap or people who are a little slower when there's a genetic defect, genetic condition present. And I'm going, no, wait, I'm highly intelligent. I'm in the, well, it's like, what's the BMR2, I think. It's one of the few tests I've actually ever had done, testing my aptitudes kind of thing. And depending on the subject matter, I'm anywhere from 88% to 96% of the world or the United States adult population performance-wise, above average to highly intelligent in different categories, and it's just an aptitude battery, 3-hour test, I don't recall taking an IQ test, except, maybe back in high school I might have, and it's like in it's like either way, I already know I was highly intelligent. I'm able to learn. I can learn by multiple means, the whole reading, handling objects, hearing someone else speak, I can learn. I don't have any problems with, learning handicap of any type. I am, again, fairly intelligent, a highly intelligent individual. Yes, I have a few genetic anomalies that make me kind of unique, but they don't hinder me mental wise. There are a lot of or there are a few doctors who will say that some of these conditions involve emotional aspects like anger and bipolar disorders kind of thing, schizophrenia, and typically, yeah, some of those could apply to some people, but just because you have a genetic condition like my own doesn't mean you are going to have any of them. I have been labeled as non-classic bipolar, which is nonsense to me. This speaks to Lucid Wins is, do you believe you've been, misdiagnosed, with mental conditions, by a practicing psychiatrist or psychologist or therapist? And I'm going, well, yeah, I've had all kinds of, other diagnoses that go along with just being clinically depressed because of the lack of treatment and understanding, compassion by medical practitioners. Depression is pretty severe, when you go to get help and you're not getting any. I generally put myself in the category of clinical depression due to medical neglect or medical stupidity. It's like if I actually had open, honest doctors, I wouldn't have any issues with depression. I've been labeled again as having a delusional gender identity disorder because of the way some of the doctors I have had have chosen to redact medical information and not include complete studies that they've done on me, medical imaging. If you don't include my studies and don't understand what I used to have at 31 years of age, known through my teens and 20s, if you don't understand what I had and what I say, this is what I used to have, and everyone else says, oh, no, I'm making stuff up, medical, psychiatrists and doctors and radiologists, if they don't acknowledge what has already been done, what I already had, then yes, I do appear to be delusional. If you take the time to look at your studies that you have done or some other hospital has performed and look at what they have provided and say, well, here, this is what I had. The change from what I had before to what I have afterwards only happens because of surgery. And because no one's acknowledged that surgery's been done to reshape what I had, I only appear to be delusional, but I'm not. I'm extremely honest, extremely open, and extremely accurate about what I had, what was previously diagnosed kind of thing. And it's like, so I'm not delusional. I'm actually accurate. And yes, there are issues with whether or not the juvenile years is a mixed structure, which has been mentioned as what I have post-surgery is what appears to be a heterogeneous structure reminiscent of a prostate due to surgery. If that's not acknowledged, if the surgery is not acknowledged to state this is what is present post-surgery and this is what used to be there, then you're going to get a misdiagnosis. And if you get a misdiagnosis like mine, you're going to get treated even worse by other medical practitioners who will go, oh, no, you're making stuff up. We know it because it says over here. Well, what it says over here is the misdiagnosis, and that's because of redacted medical records. So I'm honest, I'm accurate to my knowledge. Yeah, it's, there should be entire biopsy reports from intestines, both adrenals, because one it's gone, the other one I've got part of it left. It's like no, there's more gonadal biopsy that, at least some of the radiologists will acknowledge that yes, there's a triangle shaped wedge in the bottom of it, plaque. It's surgical scar tissue from a gonadal biopsy. I know that, and I'm not a medical professional. I'm just a student. And because they won't acknowledge it's been done, and they won't release the findings, you don't actually understand what I actually am and what's been reported about me. But since it has been reported and it has been published, I actually know I'm actually more than just XYXO. Again, imaging. Published case studies. I do believe, as previously stated many, many, many times, that there are a lot of medical practitioners who care more about being published and making money off of hurting people. I am one of the people that have been repeatedly hurt by medical practitioners. At some point in my life, I hope to meet someone who won't have that same attitude. We'll go, okay, well, this is indeed what has been done. This is what's left. This is what you are in here. These are all yours. I haven't had that yet. And I hope someday that I'll meet someone that actually is open and understanding that, you know, a lot of my issues with feeling, you know, depressed or come from the behavior that I see and witness by doctors. You know, so it's, sorry, it's just me. thinking, rambling. This is my continuation real quick of 5 days over 40 and still here, still trying to help. Again, I do have a lot of knowledge for other people. If you're looking for someone to talk to, let me know. I'll get to emails eventually. I'm not spending as much time online as I used to. It used to be 3, 4, 8 hours a night, depending on some nights before. And right now, I'm once, maybe twice a week, I'm coming online. And honestly, I just don't have a whole lot of drive to do it, spend that much time online. It's kind of tiring. Takes a toll. I do need to get out. Do need to socialize. Because it does make me feel better when I'm around other people. And it's something for people to remember. You know, even though you may not feel like going out, get outside. Go for a walk. Go to a friend's house. You know, go to the mall. Go to the movies. Do something. Because sitting at home alone has got to be one of the worst things you can do when you're depressed. Take care. Hang in there. And try to remember you're never alone. Always, always there's someone there for you. There's always people willing to help. Take care.